In this video presentation, we're going to continue the discussion on about additional protection. We know an RCD rated at 30 milliamps or below will offer additional protection to a circuit. We also know from discussions in both the classroom and the workshop that socket outlets rated at 32 amps or below will require additional protection. Remember, it's the rated value of the socket, and remember the socket outlets at home are all rated at 13 amps. We also went on to suggest that all lighting circuits in dwellings under the 18th edition require additional protection. So domestic lighting circuits now have to have RCD protection of 30 milliamps and below in order to offer that circuit additional protection. We've discussed bathrooms in the classrooms and how additional protection will be required in those areas and locations. We're going to look at one more in this presentation. We're using section 3 of the on-site guide in order to find out another one of the requirements for additional protection. It says here under 3.6.1 protection by RCDs, we've got H says the following: additional protection for cables without earth metallic covering installed within walls or partitions with metallic parts, not including the screws or nails, not protected by an earth steel conduit or likewise. So let's draw that through. So if we're going to install cables in metallic stud work, very common now in domestic and commercial installations to have a metallic frame in which the plasterboard is on one side or both in order to create a stud or false wall, we must make sure that the circuits within those, so run within those, are protected. We can do that by installing it in an earth metallic sheath cable, steel or armored. We could install a steel conduit, mineral insulated, FP200 or fire tuft. That's not very common. The likelihood is the circuits being wired in that commercial or domestic installation will be your PVC, PVC twin and CPC cables. Therefore, there is a big risk that the cable could be damaged, nicked, or pulled in and rub against the actual frame itself. Ideally, the electrician will install protection. In this case, there is a rubber grommet here in order to prevent rubbing against the actual metal frame itself, but it's not a requirement. It's good practice. I recommend that we do it. Often the hole is drilled, and when we're pulling cables in, that we could have the following. We could end up damaging the insulation around the actual conductors themselves. So this being the actual mechanical protection is damaged, and then inside maybe we've rubbed against the insulation around the copper conductors. Obviously there's a massive risk now, the risk being that we could end up nicking into our cable and this frame itself could become live. If this frame becomes live, you may not notice it. You might be touching the insulated plasterboard and never find out the fact that the frame inside is live. However, the frame could be attached to maybe a door. The door frame itself has a metal hinge. The metal hinge comes through and that's screwed into here. And therefore the metal hinge of the door could become live. And you can imagine the consequences when you're trying to paint in around that hinge. You might put some paint on the metal hinge, you might wipe it off. And only at that time you discover that the hinge has become live and there's a massive risk of electric shock to the person. So in order to overcome that, all circuits run within metal framed stud walls require either to be in earth metallic cable systems, steel or armored, etc., that we suggested earlier, or those circuits need additional protection by an RCD rated at 30 milliamps. And you can see how important it is that we make sure that they are installed with RCD protection. In the event of poor installation or damage over time, you can imagine these cables could move or vibrate, you know, people knocking into walls, just general movement of cables, that it could wear against the outside, breaking through the mechanical protection, breaking through the insulation conductions and potentially livening up the steel frame. So for that reason, under section 3, which we've been looking at in the on-site guide, we see that circuits installed in metal frame stud walls that aren't earth metallic sheath cables require additional protection by an RCD rated at 30 milliamps or below. So for this quick presentation that links to my lessons in the classroom, I hope this video has been some help.